This presentation is about sensor monitoring and data fusion techniques for early forest fire detection that were developed in the context of the AF3 European funded project. My name is Kostas Rizogiannis and I am a research associate at the National Center for Scientific Research Demokritos. Here you can see the summary of the presentation. We start with an introduction of the problem. We present the observation solutions available in the AF3 project. Then we describe the proposed scheme and we go in more detail presenting the first and the second level fusion. And finally, we explain how the BPA probabilities are assigned. When a forest fire breaks out, there is the need to act as soon as possible. A disadvantage of forest fires compared with urban ones is that they happen in remote places and they might be observed when they are in an advanced stage. A number of environmental parameters change during the fire event and a number of gases such as carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide are emitted. Hence, a detection and monitoring system could be used for early detection of the fire. In the context of AF3 project, a variety of observation solutions were used, including in-field ground sensors nodes, consisting of meteorological and atmospheric sensors, in-field ground optical camera, infrared camera mounted on a UAV, and information from other ancillary sources such as social media, web platform, and citizens' smartphone applications. We have to note that all ground sensors collect information and transmit their outputs to a centralized server. No processing takes place in the ground sensors. Only cameras transmit a decision about a fire event. For the in-field ground sensors, the rate of rise for each measured parameter is also calculated. This happens because we want to have a safety measure, since there are cases where the values of the temperature, the humidity, the carbon monoxide, or other parameters may present a disturbance in their mean value due to exogenous events or other situations. Moreover, each observation solution should also provide a probability of fire occurrence, which is necessary for the fusion of available evidence. In this slide, we can see the observation solutions adopted and the information provided by each observation solution. The infrared camera and the optical camera provide a fire or no fire decision and the location coordinates in case of a fire event. The ground sensors nodes provide a timestamp, their coordinates and measurements about pressure, temperature, relative humidity, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide and oxygen. The information from social media, web platform and citizens' smartphone applications provide the timestamp, multimedia, for example in case of a video recorded by a citizen, and the fire region is either as a polygon or as a single point. Here we can see the proposed scheme. A two-level fusion scheme was developed, combining inputs from all available observation solutions in order to improve the reliability of the fire detection system. Going in more detail, in the first level of the proposed scheme, a change point detection algorithm is used to monitor the ground sensors' measurements for changes in their mean value. Moreover, data mining algorithms monitor social media for possible fire reports. Change point detection refers to the task of detecting points in time where the statistical properties, mean value, variance, etc., of a stochastic process before and after this time point differ. The rationale of this technique is that significant changes in the mean value of the probability distribution of the measured parameters may consist a sign of fire or smoke. In this slide, we can see how a change point detection algorithm works. It detects the points where changes in the mean value of the recorded signals take place. In the second level fusion, once the sensors' measurements have been collected and the changed sensors have been identified, we have then to estimate the partially fire event basic probability assignment of the observation solutions. BPAs are the degree of confidence about a fire event. Then we proceed to the fusion process and estimate the final fire event probability. All the available BPAs from the observation solutions are fused using the Debster-Safer combination rule. Next, if the final fire event probability is higher or equal to a predefined threshold, an alert is produced. In special cases, where, for example, temperature is quite high and humidity is quite low, an alarm is immediately generated without applying the BPA estimation step and the DS combination rule. A question that arises is how do we assign BPA probabilities to sensors' findings? The assignment of BPA probabilities is realized as follows. Since for the infrared video camera and the ground optical camera, a fire, no fire output decision is provided, the BPA probability assigned to a fire event decision takes a very high value. This means that the detection accuracy of the cameras is very high. Regarding the textual information sources, an exponential function is used to assign BPA probabilities. The BPA probability is increasing with the number of the reported events. For the ground sensors nodes, a fuzzy inference system assigns a fire event BPA to the ground sensor node for which a change has been detected. For each measured parameter, a different fuzzy inference system has been created. In this slide, we can see the structure of a fuzzy inference system. It consists of the fuzzification step, the fuzzy rules, the fuzzy inference system, and the defuzzification process. Here we can see the membership function for temperature and the membership function for temperature's rate of rise. The fuzzy linguistic sets, very low, low, moderate, high, and very high, were defined. Similarly, the output membership function of fire event degree of confidence uses the linguistic set very low, low, medium, high, and very high. Next, the degree of confidence of each sensor node is computed selecting the maximum degree of confidence of the sensors that belong to the specific node. Finally, all the available BPAs from the observation solutions are fused using the Debster-Safer combination rule in order to produce the final reasoning. Thank you.